Hey, Out Late But Great, this is Jim here from Ohio, and it is Friday, and it is my turn to talk about this week's topic, which was put out there this week by Jason in Texas, and here is the question. In light of recent events with Kobe Bryant calling a referee a faggot, and a radio DJ is making gay jokes, what is your personal view about the word faggot, and how people use it? What are your views about gay jokes? When it is appropriate or not appropriate to say. How would you handle a situation where you hear the word faggot or gay jokes being swung around? Well, before I discuss this, I saw something on TV the other night. I was actually at work and I passed by a TV and I saw this really interesting commercial that was on TV, and I thought I'd share it with you, so hang on.
It's not acceptable to call me a nigger.
It's not acceptable to call me a spick.
To call me a chink.
To call me a fag.
It's not acceptable to call me a cack.
It's not acceptable to call me a retard or call yourself or your friends retarded when they do something foolish.
The R word is the same as every minority slur. Treat it that way and don't use it.
Spread the word to end the word.
So yeah, I thought that was a pretty powerful commercial. It was on a cable channel, and I actually found it on the internet, so that's why I wanted to share it with you. But boy, that really tells a lot, doesn't it? You know, you never even think of the word retard, but you know, kids use that all the time, and those kind of words just hurt people. They do. It's really sad. And well, I have to tell you the first as far as gay derogatory words, the first one that I experienced was the word sissy. Now that was back in the early, like late 60s, early 70s, and that was the big thing back then. I remember one time when my parents' neighbors, they flew out to San Francisco, and they came home and they were talking about their trip, and they said that they saw the sissies in San Francisco. And I had to laugh when my mom was telling me this, because I wanted to say to her at the time, of course, I knew I was gay, but I wasn't out yet. They didn't have to fly all the way to San Francisco to see a sissy, because there's one right here. So after that word, then the big word was queer, which at the time, you know, was very insulting and hateful and everything, but The one neat thing about the gay community is that they said screw it. They accepted that word, and now queer is used by gay people all the time as sort of who we are. We're queer. We're here. We're queer. And I know, I don't know if you remember the TV show on Showtime called Queer as Folk. I loved it. It was great. So that word kind of like lost all of its power as far as hurting people. So then the next word, of course, is faggot, which, you know, that's the big thing now. And I have to tell you, the last time I was ever called a faggot, believe it or not, was not here in Ohio. It was actually in South Beach. Dave and I had gone, this is like 3 years ago, I think. Dave and I had gone on a cruise, and I've told you about my friend Carl that lives down there. So he picked us up at the ship, and he wanted to take us to, it was called a swim party, which is, well, I'll tell you, those gay boys down there, they have a blast. They're always having parties. So, I mean, we had never been to anything like that. Like, there's the white party, and this party, and that party, but this was like a swim party. So before we went to the party, which was at a hotel, we were sitting down and having pizza at some outdoor cafe, and it was me and Dave and Carl and his boyfriend and another guy, a friend of theirs. So we were sitting there, and I could hear these people behind us like saying things like oh, it's so different down here. It's so different than up in Jacksonville. They're everywhere down here. They're everywhere. And I'm like, what? And you know, we were like, I don't know. So we were just having, actually, we weren't even drinking. We were having iced tea and pizza. So we got up to leave, and there was three people. There was a guy like in his mid-30s and two women. And we got up to leave, and the guy said something like, "Hey, fag boys, where's your wives?" So I'm like, "What?" So I turned and looked at him, and I said, "You know what? My wife is that great big hairy guy that's walking over there." And my friend Carl said, "My husband is the guy that's walking with him, but he does have a wife in Cleveland," which is true, because his boyfriend left his wife in Cleveland for Carl and moved to Fort Lauderdale. But it was funny, because I think, now these guys are big muscle heads. I mean, they're gym rats. They go to the gym every day. And I think this guy said it as we were walking away, because he didn't want a conflict. But it was funny, because I think a lot of times people with low self-esteem will throw out these words to make themselves look more important, I think. Because I think he wanted to impress the two women that he was with. So who knows? And today I heard today another word. I don't know if you guys are from the United States or whatever, but we have a couple commentators on our cable. One is called Ed Schultz, and he's a liberal, and the other one is called Laura Ingraham. Well, I guess yesterday Ed Schultz called Laura Ingraham a slut on TV, and I guess he had to apologize, and they gave him a couple days off or something. But anyway, the point of the whole story is that these words, they're just meant to hurt people. They really are. You know, if you have differences with people and you want to discuss them intelligently, that's one thing. But just to throw out these words, it doesn't make any sense, and it hurts people. It does. And with that commercial, you know, I never thought about, you know, we use the word retard, or a lot of people use that all the time, and you don't realize who that's hurting. I mean, these poor people did not choose to be mentally challenged, nor did I choose to be gay. So basically, that's basically what I had to say about that. So anyway, you guys, what a weekend. If you're here in the United States, it's Memorial Day weekend, and we've got 3 days off, which, hallelujah. I think we're just gonna get the bikes out, and the weather is supposed to be okay, although we've been having some crazy storms up here. So yeah, we're gonna do that, and there's some great parks. The metro parks in Cleveland are awesome. And there's another huge, it's called the Cuyahoga Valley National Park Forest, actually, and it's right, goes along the Cuyahoga River, and there's a lot of really neat bike trails. So we're gonna get our butts off our chairs and go out and do some bike riding, and probably cook out and stuff, and get together, I think, with Dave's mom and sister. So that's our weekend, and I hope you guys have a good weekend, and thank you, Jason, for an interesting topic this week. Take care, guys. Bye-bye.